But it was more followable than Pearl Jam on the main stage.
Right, right.
And they had to set his whole thing up, and it took a long time, and he has like a whole, like, he needs darkness for his stage show.
It must have taken 2 hours to set that stage up.
And wasn't it like daylight by the time he was into it?
Yeah. I was waking up from going to sleep, and he was just getting off, and I was just like, what?
Oh, yeah, it was awful and embarrassing. And then he does that stupid thing at the Garden, and my manager was backstage because he handled one of the other artists that was on that show, and he said they were screaming because Kanye went over by like 15 minutes. He's just a jackass. A hateable guy.
Is he up there with Scott Weiland in the hateable guy department?
You know what?
Is it a
more so, because I'll tell you what, at least Scott Weiland has drugs to blame. You know what I mean? And Kanye's a talented guy. I can't say he's not. I do like some of his stuff, and Scott Weiland's a great singer.
I don't know, man. Ego might be the most powerful drug there is.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, and it makes me hate musicians because they're so coddled. But I guess famous, like, truly famous comics and actors are too. So if they were nice to me, I wouldn't badmouth them. Anybody who's nice to me, I'm nice back to them.
Yeah.
I'm a worm.
Well put, sir. Well put. You've seen Jim Norton on Jay Leno. He's a featured contributor, I guess, is maybe the way to... What do they have? Do they have a title for
it? Not anymore. I mean, I'm actually on next Thursday. It's these little bits they do. And occasionally I'll do panel. If I need to promote something, they let me do it.
Yeah.
But it's usually just these little bits. I guess contributor, what you'd call it. I don't know why I just took your term and said no and then explained it and said yes. What a fool I am.
Speaking of promoting, you got a new CD out.
Yeah, I taped it in 2007.
Yeah.
It's called No Baby For You. It was taped along with Despicable in the same weekend. It was different nights. And I'm very happy with how it came out. Some of the material's on Monster Rain, so I don't want people to feel ripped off if they buy it. So that's why I tell them that.
My best advice for you listening is if you're like into raw, I like my humor edgy. I like it with a little bit of bite to it, if you will.
Yeah,
me too. You're not afraid to bring that.
No, I'm a creep, man. I'm dirty. I'd rather have people not come than not like dirty or aggressive humor, because I'm a pig.
I'm glad you put that out there. I remember one time I went and saw Carlin, and you know, he opens up with, hey, let's talk about the abortion issue, and you see two or three people get up, and you're like, what were you thinking you were going to get?
Right?
You went to a George Carlin show.
Yeah, well, they want the 7 dirty words, or they want, we wanted class clown. You know, they think they want what they see. I love Bob Saget's the best.
Yes.
When people show up for a good, clean show. Yeah. Oh, I love when their night is ruined.
He might be the most filthy person I've ever met. He might be.
Yeah, Bob, and he's rapid fire.
Good filthy, though.
You know? He's a piece of garbage. And again, a good friend of mine. I love Saget.
He's
the only time I ever did a Comedy Central roast is because he requested me. But they come for Full House. Bob, he's a delight. We're going to enjoy him. And then it's just incest jokes. And, oh, what a slob.
Jim is an author. He's written 2 books. You're working on your third?
Yeah, I kind of want to. I'm trying to, like, wean off the sexual addiction. It's been horrendous. So I kind of want to write, like, a true, like, a real tell-all. About that. Yeah. Yeah, really romantic novel. Starts off with me burning condoms in the street.
What do you make of chicks that feel they need to read something like that 50 Shades of Grey dreck?
I don't know. I know it's about S&M, right? I don't know much about it.
Yeah.
But I think it's just, that's how women are naughty. Like, that's their idea. I mean, when we're naughty, it's like 5 of us in a van, you know, and there's a girl with blood in her forehead thrown out of the, you know, it's like, when women get naughty, they read 50 Shades of Grey. It's like, I think it's kind of nice, because I'm sure the book stinks, but I like the fact that they're at least trying to be filthy.
Yeah.
They realize that the internet and Facebook are destroying their marriages, because what they won't do, their husbands can go online and find immediately, you can go on Ashley Madison or all these things and find girls who are kind of whorish.
Yeah.
So they're always like, oh, we should learn to do what they want. So now they're going to think they're edgy by, like, spanking you a little bit or using certain trigger words.
The internet alone is responsible for killing at least 30% of relationships.
Absolutely. You know how Facebook, my girlfriend would go through my Facebook, and she could see when I became friends with people, and it's like, it almost wrecked my relationship.
Yeah.
Almost wrecked my relationship. So you can't cheat anymore, because everything is saved, every text message you save. Years ago, a husband would want to shoot you if he saw your number on the phone bill, but now it's like, every picture I send, I have no pictures of myself above the waist on my phone. There's no reason for it. It's always with forced perspective, like me on my back with the Statue of Liberty kind of in the foreground.
You just know that's what Alexander Graham Bell had in mind. He was
eventually some guy
will
text a picture of his junk. Yeah. You'll see his junk and his sneakers and some sweats around his thighs.
You've also seen Jim Norton on David Letterman. Have you done you've never done Conan before?
No, and I wanted to do Conan. I have nothing against, I mean, I sided with Leno in the whole controversy because I genuinely love Jay.
Yeah.
But I have nothing, Conan's funny. But there was a guy who booked his the booker for him never liked me. Mm. And by there was one point where I had done like seven Tonight shows.
Is that the guy that just got blown out? Brill?
No, Eddie Brill. No, Eddie's a buddy of mine. He booked Letterman's comedy.
Oh, okay.
No, for Conan, the guy, I had done like two Letterman's and seven Tonight shows, and the guy wouldn't put me on Conan. He's like, well, we want to see a set first. And it was like, I would have showed you the set if you just put me like, you know, but he was just being, he didn't really like me, and he was just trying to, it was like that thing. So I was like, you know,
yeah.
Screw you. So I hopefully he's gone.
Got a couple more minutes left sure. Before we bump into Ziggs's show. He's got some Black Keys on the way, plus Nirvana and Linkin Park, by the way. Black Keys tickets at 5 o'clock with Ziggs this afternoon. Make sure to tune in for that.
Those guys are huge. This is how dumb I am. I did Leno once with the Black Keys, and I get a picture with everybody. I don't think I took a picture with them because I didn't know who they were.
And when Jim says he gets a picture taken with everybody, he gets a picture with everybody.
But here's the ones I missed. And believe me, I've regretted the Black Keys since I left. And I did Hannity one time with, and Chris Christie was the other guest. And I didn't know who he was because he was still running for governor of New Jersey. And now the guy's going to wind up being president. And I won't have a shot with him. I'm such a fool.
Here's me. If it's any consolation to you, Jim, here's a photo of you and me from earlier this year at Lollapalooza. So if that makes up.
Oh, you were there? Oh,
any,
cool,
in
man.
Anyway. Perform for you not getting the Black Keys. There's you and me, and then there's me with the Black Keys a couple later.
You look like you're on meth. What,
in a way,
like you're eating bath salts. What a great shot that is.
It's me. I literally just walked up to you and I just went, Jim, big fanboy.
I think I remember that. Was that in the back area?
Yes.
That was in like where all the press was, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I do. I actually remember that. You know, I took a couple of photos there.
Yep. And obviously, Sabbath, you were there for Sabbath. You're a stupid, huge Aussie fan.
Yeah, I got to interview Tony, Ozzy, and Geezer together. It was amazing.
You're kind of the house interviewer now at this point, don't you think, for Sharon?
Well, she trusts me with them because she knows that I would never I would never hurt Ozzy publicly.
Yeah.
I do a show on Ozzy's Boneyard too on Sirius, so they're very good to me.
Well, we're going to bring this conversation to a close. I want to encourage people once again to follow Jim on Twitter or check out his website. He's mentioned a couple times that he's working on it again.
Yeah, it's horrible.
There's an interesting, awesome psychosis going on with this guy, and it's just flat out funny. And you should really go and check him out tonight at Zanies or check him out tomorrow or Saturday. He's in town. We're going to get him in here in Nashville on a regular basis.
Yeah, I would like to. It's been 5 years.
With the Free Beer and Hot Wings comedy series of shows. Hey, buddy, thanks for coming by the studio. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You. And you'll enjoy my website if you have Internet Explorer and it's 1998. go knock yourselves out.
At least you didn't say like Netscape.
No, I meant Internet Explorer 1, the first one. It sucks.
Prodigy. Jim Norton at Zanies tonight. Ziggs is in next. We'll get him started with some Linkin Park. That's next. Electronic Express.